morning again. So yesterday we did the formulas related to continuous series, direct method, shortcut method, as well as step deviation method. So I hope you have memorized these formulas, right? Because these are same as that of discrete series. Only one difference is there. There you have to multiply x corresponding frequency. Here you have to multiply m, that is mid values, with the corresponding frequency. Because continuous series are of different types, so we will be covering all types of continuous series. In the first question, I will be taking the simplest case, that is of exclusive series, right? So here we will be solving or calculating arithmetic mean using all the methods, direct method, shortcut method, and step deviation method. In future, in all other series, we will be following just one method. And can you tell me which method we should preferably make use of if the examiner has not specified any particular method? But in that case, we should make use of step deviation method. ठीक है, continue series में अगर कोई method specified नहीं हुआ किया हुआ examiner ने, तो make use of step deviation method. No hard and fast rule, but then it is, you know, the simplest way to solve it. So write down the question, bete. First of all, different cases we will be covering. So case A is that of exclusive series. You note it down, exclusive series. And then write down the question. Calculate arithmetic mean. Calculate arithmetic mean use direct method, shortcut method, and step deviation method. Note down the question. You are given marks, which I am considering as variable x. You can leave one space here. मार्क्स के नीचे आप एक जगह एक नेक्स्ट लाइन में एक्स लिख सकते हैं. 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70. नेक्स्ट कॉलम नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स, विच इज फ्रीक्वेंसी, एज 12, 20, 25, 20, 10 and 5. This is a continuous series. We have to make use of direct method. So as I told you already, firstly, bete, we will be making use of, we will be writing the formula. Summation Fm upon summation F, right? So first thing is to calculate mid values M. 0 plus 10 divided by 2, 5. 10 plus 20 divided by 2. So because all of them are equal class intervals, so you need not, you know, plus them and divided by 2. You just see the class interval, size of class interval, it is of 10. So you add 10 to every mid value. Your purpose will be solved. Right. Next bit, you need F into M. This is our F column. This is M. So multiply mid values with their corresponding frequencies. Okay. F into M. 8 into 5, 40. 12. Into 15, 180. 20 into 25, 500. 25 into 35. That is 875. 20 into 45. 10 into 55. 65 into 5. That is 325. Now, any student who is entering into the class, if they call you, tell them I'm not allowing them in, because one thing, there is no profile pic, and another, they do not, they are coming quite late in the class, right? It's already 8:43, so I will not be allowing these students in. So FM is there, we want its total, so hum total le lete hain iska. 5, 5, 10, 5, 8, 13, 20, 25, 27, 2, 3, 8, 8, 16, 9, 25, 30, 3, 3, 7, 0. Nalin is not there in the class. Okay. So, बेटे इसका total ले ले, इसका भी total ले लो. ठीक है. Now put the values in the formula. Summation FM, that is 3370 divided by 100. So x bar comes out to be 33.70 हम नहीं लगाते होते, ठीक है, 33.7. So average marks of this class is 33.7. Sorry. So now let's do this very question only using shortcut method. So write down, calculate arithmetic mean. Sorry, statement हमने already लिखी हुई है बेटे. ठीक है, तो अब हम यूजिंग शॉर्टकट मेथड दोबारा से ये नोट डाउन कर लेते हैं क्वेश्चन. राइट, बी फास्ट. शॉर्टकट मेथड से आई एम राइटिंग डाउन फॉर्मूला. एक्स बार इक्वल्स A plus summation FDM over summation F. Bete, whatever method you use in continuous series, the first step is to find out the mid values, right? So here is our X variable. Here is the column of frequency. These are the mid values. Right, now look at the formula. You will come to know about the steps to be followed. Firstly, you need to find out the value of A, assumed mean. Assumed mean, you can take any value as an assumed mean from mid value, right? I am taking, say, 35 as an assumed mean. So now I will be taking deviations from assumed mean. This is column DM, which is mid value, that is M minus A. A we have decided to be 35. So you can simply write M minus 35. 5 minus 35, 15 minus 35, 25 minus 35, 35 minus 35, 45 minus 35, 55 minus 35. 65 minus 35. ठीक है, सो बेटे डू नॉट टेक इट्स टोटल, देयर इज नो नीड, बिकॉज़ वी हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई इट विद कॉरेस्पोंडिंग फ्रीक्वेंसीज. नेवर फॉरगेट, एफ कॉलम इज देयर, यू हैव टू मेक यूज ऑफ एफ. आई समटाइम्स इन ऑर्डर टू मेक इट सिट इन योर माइंड, आई टेल द स्टूडेंट्स एफ इज योर फ्रेंड, whenever you go, you always take your friend along. ठीक है? So taking your friend along, f into dm, 8 into minus 30, 12 into minus 20, 20 into minus 10, 25 into 0, 20 into 10, again 10 into 20, 30 into 5. ठीक है? So बच्चे जनरली इसको ऐसे कर लेते हैं. ठीक है, ये अब 200 में से ये 40 रह गया. और यहाँ आप ऐसे कर लो जैसे आपको बेटे जिस तरह से आपको हैबिट पड़ी हुई अपने सॉल्व करने की, यू कैन डू इट. नो हार्ड एंड फास्ट रूल इज देयर. दिस इज 350 एंड दिस इज 480, माइनस करके इसमें से आगे आंसर माइनस 130. ठीक है, एम आई राइट? सो पुटिंग द वैल्यूज इन द फॉर्मूला, x बार equals assumed mean is 35, summation FDM is minus 130. So always write plus here, only then you write minus, right? Summation F is 100, we have already calculated. So 0 0 cut gaya bete, you are left with minus 1.3. So this is x bar equals 33.7. Now Deepak, Dhruv, Isha and Gurkirat, D and E, these students, they will show me their notebooks. Deepak, Isha, Gurkirat, Dhruv. Okay, Gurkirat has shown. Isha, Deepak and Dhruv both are left. Yes, Dhruv. Now what's there with you? Now calculate arithmetic mean using step deviation method. So same statement, you will note down. You are given x, you are given f. X is given class intervals, that is, it is a continuous series. So first step always is to find out its mid values. So we will be finding out its mid values, jotting it down. Right. So let's write down the formula of step deviation, which is x bar equals a plus summation f d dash m upon summation f into c. So we know that we have to find out a first of all. Now let's take any other value as an assumed mean. Say I am taking 25 as an assumed mean. ठीक है, इससे हमारा ये भी पता चल जाएगा कि arithmetic mean is independent of change of origin. Which means we take any value as an assumed mean, we will be getting the same answer. Now, DM, which is M minus A, A I have taken to be 25. 5 minus 25, 15 minus 25, 25 minus 25, right? Now you see that 10 is a common factor here. As I told you previously also, the common factor is equal to class interval, size of class interval. So C is say size of class interval here. So we will be dividing DM with C, where C is equal to 10. So बेटे आपको क्या करना है, क्योंकि 10 से डिवाइड करना है तो एक जीरो रिमूव हो जाएगा. Then D dash M has to be multiplied with their corresponding frequencies. So you'll be getting another column F into D dash M. 8 into minus 2, 12 into minus 1, 0, 25, 40, 39. Okay? Inko separately add kar lenge. Right? Are you doing along with me? बेटे साथ साथ करेंगे तभी एग्जाम्स में हो पाएंगे आपसे. ठीक है, दिस इज 76. सो लेट्स पुट द वैल्यूज इन द फॉर्मूला. I have taken assumed mean to be 25, right? Summation f d dash m 76 over 100 into 10. Let's see, I guess some calculation mistake is there. So summation f d dash m is 87. जीरो जीरो कट गया. एक्स बार इक्वल्स 25 प्लस 8.7. एक्स बार इक्वल्स 33.7. सो वी हैव सीन दैट एनी मेथड यू मेक यूज ऑफ यू विल गेट द सेम आंसर. Second case is that of inclusive series, bete. So write down the question. You are asked to calculate arithmetic mean. No method is specified to us. So it's up to us which method we want to make use of. As I told you, it is always advisable in case of continuous series to make use of step deviation method. 5, 10, 20, 12, 8, 3. But as you can see, this is an inclusive series. So in case of inclusive series, but there is no need to convert it into exclusive series before calculating arithmetic mean, right? Before calculating arithmetic mean, there is no need to convert inclusive series into exclusive series. Simply find out the mid values and solve the sum as it is. So, bete mid value 0 plus 9, 9. 9 divided by 2, 4.5. Here, 29 divided by 2, 14.5. So, making use of our common sense, that is by adding 10, we will be getting succeeding mid values. These are our mid values. Now, firstly, we will be writing down the formula now. A plus summation f d dash m over summation f into c. So again, first step is to take any value as an assumed mean. I'm taking this as an assumed mean. So let's find out dm, which is m minus a. A is 34.5. 4.5 minus 34.5 minus 30. Right? Now you can see 10 is a common factor here. Mid value में succeeding difference 10 का है. तो 10 common factor हो गया. हम 10 से DM के column को divide कर देंगे. D dash M आ गया. इसको इसकी corresponding frequencies के साथ multiply कर देंगे. 5 into minus 3, 10 into minus 2, 20 into minus 1, 12 into 0, 8 into 8, 3 into 2. So this is 14. 14 is minus 1 reh gaya, minus 41. Calculations check karte jana bete saath saath. Aapne apni karni hai, meri note down nahi karni. Minus 41 over this was 100 into 10. ठीक है 34.5 minus 4.1. So x bar 34.5 में से 4.1 sorry minus हो गया. Answer is 34.5.